Something else that really seems to change with fasting is the NAD levels.
Yes.
And that's something that, you know, your lab has studied extensively with the sirtuins. And
yes.
So maybe could you talk a little bit about, because NAD is also extremely exciting to me, and it's pretty popular these days as well.
Yes. So NAD has emerged as one of these critical intermediary metabolites. Think of ketone bodies, NAD are all, I call them currencies. I mean, so think about your organism as a country. You need to circulate energy, and NAD is one way that our body is utilizing within the cell to convert, to transfer energy. It's almost like the Brinkman truck that carries the money. And NAD can actually is a so-called hydride acceptor during while we oxidize food. It can actually serve as an acceptor for electron, and it can transfer them, for example, to the respiratory chain. So it's one way for the energy to be circulated within the cell. And there's growing evidence that its level decreases during aging. Why that happens is still one of the big mysteries. And so this has yielded a whole approach that trying to understand first, what are the consequences of decreased NAD levels? And one of the consequences is that enzymes like sirtuins, which rely on NAD to exert all of their beneficial activities, actually function less well. That's what happens during aging. But also many other enzymes that are involved in our metabolism are relying on NAD, and so they function less well. So your intermediary metabolism functions less well. The sirtuins, which are global regulators, function less well.
Falling apart.
yeah, essentially, you know, everything becomes a little less
yeah,
a little less efficient. So out of these discoveries came the idea that maybe we should replenish the decreasing level of NAD. Mm-hmm. And this has yielded some discoveries such as nicotinamide ribosides,
right,
nicotinamide mononucleotides, which are now being taken by a lot of people, and with the hope that it will correct some of these problems.
Yeah.
One word of caution, I think, there is we do not know why these levels decrease. They could decrease because we have decreased production of NAD, but it could also decrease because we have accelerated destruction of NAD, which means if it's accelerated destruction, bringing more into it is sort of like pouring more NAD in a leaky sink. Mm-hmm. So I think a lot of our work right now is trying to understand what is the cause of the decrease in NAD during aging. Because I think it will yield very different solutions. If you find that there's a leaky sink, well,
yeah,
we'll work at filling, at plugging the sink,
yeah,
versus keeping pouring water.
I have a theory.
Yes.
So I know, you know, coming from, I did a lot of work with DNA damage.
Yes.
And knowing that one of the main enzymes.
PARP.
Exactly.
Yes.
I mean, if you think about, you know, so one of the main enzymes that repairs damage as we age, DNA damage, PARP, requires NAD. And it's like, if you're accumulating more and more damage as you age, you have to repair more of that damage. And more damage you're having, maybe it's sucking the NAD, you know, sort of like almost a triage where it's like, well, you got to keep repairing that damage. So then other things like the mitochondria suffer, or, you know, so.
I completely agree. And actually there are two major theories right now that have been proposed in terms of why doesn't NAD go down. One is activated PARP. And indeed, as we age, we accumulate DNA damage. It's been shown, especially in the brain recently. And so the idea is by activating PARP, you can constantly deplete your NAD levels. The second one is we all have in our body a so-called salvage pathway for NAD, because NAD turns over. There's a so-called salvage pathway that allows it to be recycled back to, so we can get NAD from the food, but also we salvage the one that we utilize.
Right.
And this salvage pathway has been shown to become paralyzed while you age. Mm. There's an enzyme called NAMPT that has received a lot of attention. That enzyme tends to be inhibited by chronic inflammation and a high fat diet. So one way, so it could be a combination of both of these things, but it could be other mechanisms. Actually, we're working yet on another mechanism, which is that there might be accelerated destruction by other enzymes beyond PARP, mm-hmm. and getting some exciting results in this direction.
Cool.